if the Netherlands draw or win the game, they have definitely qualified. But to win the group, they would have to beat Qatar and hope that Ecuador lose. But let's see. Okay, here we go. Stop using the screen. Netherlands, Qatar. Here we go. First game. Final game of group A. Two. Netherlands 2. Qatar 4. Qatar did get a win, and this might mess up Holland's chance. Because as it stands, the Netherlands are second, but if Senegal get a draw, goal difference isn't good enough. They need to win. I know, it's the hold on. Yes, it is. A draw would be enough. A draw would be enough for Ecuador to go through. Sorry, Senegal to go through. Almost enough. Anyway, let's roll the dice. Here we go. Ecuador versus Senegal. Ecuador 1, Senegal 0. What does that do to the group? I think Portugal have, sorry, I think Netherlands have just got through. They have. They've all played the games. Ecuador, top of the group of 7. Netherlands go through second with 4 points. The Senegal just missing out. Qatar getting 3 points. These will be good result in the end. I mean, they didn't have a great result in the first 2 matches. But Ecuador and Senegal will qualify, as you can see, we're not outstage below. Now, can England save themselves? Are England going out in the group stage? Okay, this is Scotland, England. Scotland, England. Here we go, Scotland. 5. England are out. England are going out. Even if they draw, they can't go through. England, Scotland 5. And even worse, they've lost 5-0 to their biggest, oldest rivals. The biggest, oldest rival game in football history, international history, is ended Scotland 5, England 0. Which means Scotland will top the group. Doesn't matter what Iran and USA do. But one of them has qualified, so let's see who it is. Iran 5. USA 2. So there you go. This is why rolling the dice. This is definitely different to what would happen in reality. Iran 5, USA 2, so which means Scotland, Iran, are qualified, USA 2nd, and England bottom, minus 6, conceded 12 goals. Incredible. Incredible. The only result they had was a 4-4 with the USA. Wow, okay, let's go to group C. Argentina. Let's look at the group. Argentina top group, 4 points, Mexico 3, Poland 3, Saudi Arabia 1, so they can all go through. This is up for grabs right now, for anybody. I think the big game is Poland, Argentina match. It's all big. I think this first match will decide it. Here we go, Poland 2. Argentina, here we go. 0-0. I wasn't expecting that. 2-0. I don't see when they win for Poland. They don't concede many goals. Well, apart from the 5 to Mexico. But they've clean sheets in the last 2 matches, which means Poland now on 6. Argentina on 4, in danger of going out. Because if Mexico get a draw, they'll be on to 4. But the Poland will probably win. So Saudi Arabia would need to win big time as well. Okay, so here we go. Argentina might have got a little bit of luck, but we'll see. Mexico would have to win about 4, like 3 or 4 goals. Saudi Arabia 0. That's the best start of Mexico. Saudi Arabia 0. Mexico 4. Are they through? Let's see. Let's put a result in and see what's on the table. And Mexico, they're good as qualified. They qualified top. Mexico 6 points. Poland 6 points. Argentina 4 points. They're going home. Mexico and Poland are going through to the next round. And here it is. You guys want to see some of the games that are coming up? Ecuador, Iran, Scotland, Netherlands. And then these are the games to be settled. Okay, group D. Denmark, Tunisia, France, and Peru. Peru can't go through. Because 4 points is the top. So, let's put these scores in. Tunisia, 4. France, 0. Wow, sacre bleu, let me say. Because France are out. They played 3, but they got 3 points. It doesn't matter what happens in this match. France are out, the world champions are out. So let's finish off the group. Peru, 3. Denmark, 3. Great game, and massive amount of goals in this Dice World Cup. But anyway, Tunisia win the group, Denmark second, France are out on 3 points, and Peru also out for just the 1 point. And there's the top master then draws. There's the Poland, there's Scotland, there's Netherlands, Ecuador, Iran, Mexico, Denmark. Who would have expected that in reality? Okay, here we go, into group E, where Spain are definitely through. Whether they finish top is even matter. And Spain will play Japan, and New Zealand business will play Germany. Okay, let's put this one to touch. We're going to Japan against Spain first. Here we go, Japan. 5. They will win the group if they win the game. Spain won. They have won the group. Spain have gone through and Japan have gone through. Oh, hold on. Spain could go out. Depends on the result. New Zealand Germany match. Okay, here we go. New Zealand 2. Germany 3. Germany do get a win in the end against New Zealand or whatever team it is. I'm sure it's New Zealand. Can't go out. Guys, that's the way about that. But Germany bottom of the group again in the World Cup. They were bottom in 2018 in reality. You're right. But Japan and Spain will go through in first and second place. Incredible. Okay, group F. Oh. Group F, the group of literally, all of these are qualifying. It's Croatia, Belgium. Top 2. Let's see what this group means. Is it Croatia's turn again or Belgium's turn? Croatia 1. Belgium 3. So Belgium 1, Croatia 3. Belgium on top on 6. Croatia are still second because of fourth, but if Morocco win by certain length against Scotland, they're going to be second, and Canada can still go through, but they would have to win by a couple of goals, two, three goals against Morocco. That's the only way Canada can qualify, so let's see what happens. Here we go, Canada, Morocco. Canada, in the second World Cup, 2, Morocco, 0. Is it enough? I don't think it's enough. It's not enough. Oh, bless Canada, 4 points. They missed out by 1 goal. Look, they scored 11. Croatia scored 11. But they conceded 10 goals, Canada. Croatia, if they'd won 3-0 instead of 2-0, they would be second. That's how close it is. So Belgium go through and Croatia go through in group F, the group of death. Now here we go into Brazil, Serbia, Cameroon, and Switzerland's group. Let's just get straight on with it. Cameroon against Brazil. Brazil have qualified, you expect, but Cameroon 3, Brazil 4. Well, definitely, won all 3 games. So Brazil have won all matches. This is probably the only scenario in this DICE World Cup where that probably could be true, where Brazil won all 3 games. So Cameroon 3, Brazil 4, Serbia against Switzerland. The Swiss can win. If the Swiss win, they get second place. Serbia's just in a draw. Serbia 1. If this is a 0 or 1, Serbia are through. If it's anything more, Switzerland are through. It's 4. So the Swiss beat Serbia 4-1 and qualify in second place. 9 points, 4 points, 3 points, 1. This could be the actual table, but in reality, looking at the score lines, but the table, for sure. Okay, let's move into Group H. Where we have Ronaldo, Suarez and Cavani, Son and Spurs, and Ghana. Sorry, I don't know any Ghana players. But let's go on the matches. South Korea and Portugal. South Korea, they're probably already through. They are. They're plus 6. They can't mess this up. But let's do the scoreline. Here we go. South Korea, 1. Portugal win the group. 2. Do they win the group? Do they win the group though? And they don't. I'm going to put it down. But they're up for 6 points. Now, if Ghana would have to win 5-0, Ghana would have to win 5-0, literally, to put them onto 6 points and a better goal difference than Portugal. That's the only way Ghana can win, okay? So let's see what happens. Ghana, Uruguay. Ghana. Oh, so close. Ghana 4, Uruguay 2. So they gave it a big shot. They gave it their best Ghana. They did what they had to do to win the match. But, because of goal difference, they didn't go through. But they did get the 40 win against Uruguay. That is redemption after the 2010 World Cup with Suarez's handball and went out penalties. And could have been the first team into a semi-final of the World Cup. Okay, so here we go. This is our quarter-final lineup. Let's try and get closer in on this. So our first game, Ecuador will play Iran. Mexico against Denmark. Japan against Croatia. Brazil against Portugal. Scotland against the Netherlands. Tunisia against Poland. Belgium against Spain. And South Korea against Switzerland. How cool is that? That's amazing, okay? That's amazing. Who am I putting through? What's that? Well, it's not up to me. It's up to the DICE. So we'll do the DICE knockout stages in the next video. I hope you enjoyed it. And we'll see you next time. Goodbye.